Yes? If yes, give me a thumbs up. Okay, perfect. Okay. Fine. Okay, so let's begin. So last class, we spoke about light reaction. Okay, someone else has also come in. Yeah, so last class, we basically spoke about light reaction, if you remember, right? Okay, so let's revise what we did in light reaction. So as we know, light reaction takes place in the grana of the chloroplast. Where does it take place? It takes place in the grana of the chloroplast. Okay. Now, why should the light reaction take place in the grana and not other regions of the chloroplast? Because for light reaction to take place, sunlight is required. And that sunlight is basically going to be absorbed by chlorophyll. And since this chlorophyll is present in the thylakoid or the grana, that is why the light reaction takes place in the grana. Okay? So in light reaction, the first step is light energy is going to be absorbed by the chlorophyll molecule. Okay? Light energy or sunlight is basically going to be absorbed by chlorophyll molecule. Now, after the chlorophyll molecule absorbs the sunlight, what are they going to do with that sunlight? That sunlight is going to be used for something called as photolysis of water. For something called as photolysis of water. Okay. Now, what is photolysis of water? Photolysis of water means water molecule is going to break down in the presence of sunlight. What is it? Water molecule is going to break down in the presence of sunlight. So when water molecule breaks down in the presence of sunlight, what do we get? We get hydrogen ions, we get electrons, and we get oxygen, right? Now, this oxygen molecule, I told you, is a waste product. So plants are going to release this oxygen molecule into the atmosphere. So this oxygen will be released, okay? Now, next, what is going to happen to the electron? This electron is going to be used for the formation of ATP molecule, that is adenosine triphosphate. It is going to be used for what? The formation of ATP molecule, that is adenosine triphosphate. And this ATP is nothing but called as chemical energy. This ATP is nothing but called as chemical energy. So electron will be used for the formation of ATP, and this ATP is your chemical energy. Okay. Now the next one, hydrogen ion. This hydrogen ion is going to be accepted by a hydrogen acceptor in plants. What have I told you last class? Hydrogen acceptor means it is going to combine with hydrogen ion. Okay. Hydrogen acceptor means it is going to combine with hydrogen ion. So, okay, one more person has joined in. So, this hydrogen ion is basically going to be absorbed, or it is going to react with the hydrogen acceptor in plant. And what is that hydrogen acceptor in plant? NADP molecule. What is it? NADP molecule. That is NADP. That is N stands for nicotinamide. Here you can see that. A stands for adenine. D stands for dinucleotide. And P stands for phosphate. So the full form of NADP is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. So this is the hydrogen acceptor that is already present in the plants. So this NADP is going to accept this hydrogen ions that is produced by photolysis of water. And when NADP accepts the hydrogen ion, what is going to be produced? Then that time, it is going to produce something called as NADPH. Now, what is NADPH? Last time I told you the abbreviation for NADPH, but once again, I'm going to repeat. So, see, now there's something called as oxidation and reduction. Right. So here, oxidation is basically when it combines with oxygen. And reduction means when it combines with hydrogen. So here, NADP has accepted the hydrogen. So basically, what has taken place? Reduction has taken place, correct? So NADP, after accepting hydrogen ion, gets converted into NADPH. So the full form of NADPH is basically reduced form of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. So you just need to add the word reduced, and then you need to tell the same abbreviation of NADP. That is the full form of NADPH. Okay? Yes? So that is what is happening in photolysis of water. Electrons, hydrogen ions and oxygen. Electron will be used for the formation of ATP. Hydrogen will be accepted by NADP. And NADP will form NADPH. Okay? Now, the last step of light reaction. As I told you, As chemical energy is produced, that is ATP, the light energy is going to be converted into chemical energy. So the light, that energy, that is a light, sunlight, that has been absorbed by chlorophyll, that has been converted into chemical energy. How? By the formation of ATP. Because I mentioned ATP is nothing but chemical energy. So these are the steps of light reaction. Repeating once again, the first step of light reaction, absorption of sunlight by chlorophyll. The second step of light reaction, photolysis of water. And when water undergoes photolysis, it is going to produce hydrogen ions, oxygen and electron. Oxygen is going to be released into the atmosphere. The electron is going to be used for the formation of ATP. And this ATP is nothing but chemical energy. The hydrogen ion is going to be accepted by a hydrogen acceptor in the plant. And this hydrogen acceptor in the plant is nothing but NADP molecule, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. Now this NADP, after combining with hydrogen ion, it forms NADPH, that is reduced form of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. And the third step of light reaction is conversion of light energy to chemical energy. So the light that has been absorbed by chlorophyll, it has been converted into chemical energy by formation of ATP molecule. Thus, during light reaction, two products are produced. Two main products are produced. The first product is our ATP and the second product is our NADPH. Okay, so NADPH is one of the product of light reaction and ATP is the other product of light reaction. What are we going to do? That is, what are the plants going to do with these products? You'll understand that in the second step of photosynthesis that we'll be discussing. But till here, you all are having any doubts or you all have not understood? If you all have understood, give me a thumbs up. Okay. Okay. Fine. This is clear cut, right? If y'all have doubts, just message me, okay? You can message me on the chat in case y'all are having any doubts, or else I'm going to proceed ahead. Okay, so let's proceed ahead. So here you can see this is an animation of light reaction. So I'm again showing it to you. So we have a light, we have a water. So you can see water molecule is splitting up, that is breaking down. And when it breaks down, it produces hydrogen, okay? And oxygen also. Oxygen will be released, right? And also during light reaction, there is formation of ATP also. You can see after water molecule breaks down, there's formation of ATP, oxygen, and the hydrogen is accepted by NADP to form NADPH. So this is what happens in light reaction or light dependent phase, because it requires sunlight. That is why we also call it as a light dependent phase. This entire steps of light reaction that I told you is taking place in the grana of the chloroplast. Very, very important. Okay. Now, after this, we go ahead with the second phase of photosynthesis that is called as dark reaction. So, as I told you in the last class also, I told you dark reaction, basically the name tells you that it will take place during the dark. No. Dark reaction basically means that it does not require sunlight. So because it does not require sunlight, it is called as light independent phase. What is it called as? Light independent phase. Okay. But that does not mean that it will take place in the nighttime only. No, it can take place during the daytime also. It can take place in the daytime also. But only thing is, it will not utilize the sunlight. So if it is not going to utilize the sunlight, so what exactly happens in the dark reaction? Let us see that. So now, dark reaction, okay, also called as a light independent phase. Now, what I told you, dark reaction takes place in the stroma. Why should dark reaction take place in the stroma? Because, because whatever enzymes are required for the dark reaction to take place, those enzymes are present in the stroma of the chloroplast. Those enzymes are present in the stroma of the chloroplast. That is why dark reaction takes place in the stroma. Have you all understood? If you have understood, please give me a thumbs up. Okay. Fine. Amay, Anushka. Okay. Piyush, understood? Riya? Okay. Fine. Archisha, Parth, Mustaba, Isha, all of you have understood what I spoke. Okay. Mustaba and Parth. Okay. Now some of you all. Yes, Gayatri. Where is Gayatri? Gayatri. Archisha and Gayatri. Yeah. Gayatri.
Ma'am, can you explain once again?
Which part can you want me to? Yeah, which part?
The dark reaction.
Okay, dark reaction. I'm explaining once again. And even Archisha, 1 minute. You can mute yourself, Gayatri. I'll just go to Archisha. Archisha also raised a problem. Yeah. Archisha.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, what happened? You got disconnected in between?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you want me to repeat dark reaction once again, right?
Yes.
Okay, so fine. Okay, so as some students were disconnected, I'm just repeating dark reaction. So basically, understand one thing. Dark reaction does not require sunlight. That is why we call dark reaction as light independent phase. So dark reaction does not mean that it will take place only during the night time. Okay, dark means night. So we associate it with night. So that means it takes place in the night time. No, it can also take place during the daytime. So dark reaction can take place during the daytime as well as it can take place during the night time also. Okay. And dark reaction takes place in the stroma of the chloroplast. Okay, dark reaction takes place in the stroma of the chloroplast. Why in the stroma of the chloroplast? So here you can see stroma of the chloroplast. Why in the stroma? Because whatever enzymes are required for the dark reaction to take place, those enzymes are present in the stroma. So that is the main reason why dark reaction takes place in the stroma of the chloroplast. Okay. Now, what exactly happens in dark reaction? See, till now we know the raw materials of photosynthesis are carbon dioxide and water. Correct? Now, water, we have already spoken about what happens to water in light reaction. But till now, we haven't spoken about what happens to carbon dioxide. So that we are going to talk in dark reaction. Okay. So in dark reaction, carbon dioxide is going to get converted into the main food product of the photosynthesis or of the plant. And what is that main food product of the plant or photosynthesis? It is nothing but glucose, right? It is nothing but glucose. So, in dark reaction, your carbon dioxide is going to get reduced or is going to get converted to glucose. Okay, it is going to get converted to glucose. So this conversion of carbon dioxide to glucose is actually called as reduction. It is actually called as reduction. So in certain books, you will see that that in dark reaction, it is written as carbon dioxide is reduced to glucose. So reduce is nothing but getting converted to glucose. So how do you think in dark reaction, carbon dioxide gets reduced to glucose? So if you remember our ATP, so I'll just show you the pointer. So if you remember our ATP and our NADPH, who are they? They are the products of the light reaction, right? So this products of the light reaction are going to be used in the dark reaction. They are going to be used in the dark reaction. Why are they going to be used in the dark reaction? So that carbon dioxide gets converted or gets reduced to glucose. So in dark reaction, ATP and NADPH will be utilized for reducing or for converting the CO2 to glucose. Are you all understanding? This is what happens in dark reaction. This is what happens in dark reaction. Any doubts? If not, just give me a thumbs up that you all have understood. If you have doubts, please message me on the chat section. Okay. Parth, have you understood? Isha and Parth? Okay, Tiaz, Bhumija, Anushka, Mustafa, understood? Okay. Piyush? Fine. Gayatri? Gayatri is understood. If you all have doubts regarding light reaction and dark reaction, you can just message me on the chat. Okay. Okay, let's go ahead now. Now, always remember, dark reaction is dependent on light reaction. Why? Because, yes, someone has messaged me. Just a moment. Yes. Yes, Sai, the reduction of your carbon dioxide to glucose takes place in the stroma. Okay? Okay, so dark reaction is dependent on the light reaction. Okay, why is it that? Because I told you in dark reaction, ATP and NADPH has to be used, right? So this ATP and NADPH are produced in light reaction. So that is why dark reaction is dependent on the light reaction for ATP and NADPH. Fine, but do you all think light reaction is also dependent on dark reaction? Yes. Light reaction is also dependent on dark reaction. How? Let us see that now. See here. So here in light reaction, ATP is going to dark reaction. Okay. So you can see after ATP goes to dark reaction, let me show you all again. Concentrate. So you can see that. Yeah, ATP is going to the dark reaction and ATP is getting converted to ADP and phosphate. Now, what is this ADP and phosphate? Let us see that. So I'll just write it for you all. So I'm writing it here, okay? ADP is called as adenosine diphosphate. What is it called as? Adenosine diphosphate. Okay. And our ATP is what? Adenosine triphosphate. That means tri means three. Di means two. Okay. That means adenosine diphosphate has two phosphate groups and adenosine triphosphate has three phosphate group. Okay. So ATP is made from ADP. How? So you can see here ATP is made from ADP. How? ADP reacts with phosphate. Okay. So write it this side so it becomes clear for you all. Yeah. So Yeah. So ADP, already it has two phosphate. So if I add one more phosphate, P stands for phosphate. So if I add one more phosphate to ADP, what will it become? ATP. So that is why ATP is produced from ADP and phosphate. So that is when ATP is used, when ATP is used, ATP gets converted back to ADP. What happens? ATP gets converted back to ADP. Why? Because ATP is used. Okay. So when the ATP goes to the dark reaction, I told you ATP is used. So when ATP is used, what will happen? ATP will get converted to ADP and phosphate. Correct? ATP will get converted to ADP and phosphate. Now, if this ADP and phosphate does not go back to light reaction, then light reaction will not take place. Why? Because this ADP and phosphate is again required for forming ATP, which takes place in light reaction. So light reaction is dependent on dark reaction for ADP and phosphate, whereas dark reaction is dependent on light reaction for ADP and phosphate. Are you all understanding? Yes or no? That is, give me a thumbs up if you all have understood this concept. Okay. Oh, whoever has a doubt, y'all can message me in case y'all are having a doubt in this particular part. Okay. So let's go ahead now. So light reaction and dark reaction are dependent, that we got to know. But one more thing, if you remember NADPH, right? Okay. NADPH, I'll write it on the text format so that will be easier for you all to understand. Yeah. So NADPH, right? That was produced in the light reaction. That is used up in the dark reaction, correct? So when NADPH is used, what is produced? NADP is produced. What is produced? NADP is produced. So again, if this NADP doesn't go back to the light reaction, again NADPH will not be produced. If NADP does not go back to the light reaction, NADPH will not be produced. So that is why light reaction is not only dependent on the dark reaction for ADP and phosphate, but it is also dependent on the dark reaction for NADP molecule. So that is why from this we conclude that light and dark reaction both are interdependent on each other. Both are what? Interdependent on each other. So I'm going to play this animation for y'all so that again things become clear. Okay, so you can see this water is breaking down, giving you oxygen. ATP is going to dark reaction. ATP is coming in the form of ADP, which goes to light reaction. Carbon dioxide is coming in the dark reaction. It is getting converted to glucose. Can y'all see that? Yes. So this is what is all about light reaction and dark reaction. Okay. What y'all could do is y'all could take a screenshot. Okay, y'all could take a screenshot in your mobile phone. If y'all are having laptop, then y'all could ask people in your group to share the screenshot with y'all in the group of whatever I'm teaching. So these things remain with you so that it becomes easier for y'all to study, because some students still they don't have the textbook. Okay, so y'all can take a screenshot while I'm teaching y'all. Fine. Okay. Any doubts till here? If you have understood everything till here, please give me a thumbs up. Okay. Okay. Fine. You understood? Okay. Mustafa understood? Sahi understood? Okay. Piyush, Anushka? Fine. Shravani, Himani, Himanshi? Have you understood? Himani, Himanshi? Bhumija, Tiaz, Vijay. Have you all understood? Okay. Tiaz, have you understood? Tiaz. Okay, Tiaz is not connected. Fine. Archisha, Aryan, Isha, Parth, and someone Oppo. I don't know who's that Oppo. Parth and this Oppo. Have you all understood? Yes? Okay. So let's go ahead now. So I'll just erase these things. So this is the same thing. This is the same animation. So we have completed the mechanism of photosynthesis, wherein you can see the light. So you can see the light coming in, and the sunlight, and with the help of chlorophyll, carbon dioxide and water react with each other to produce the sugar, that is glucose, okay, and oxygen. Now, very, very important. Now we are going to study about a concept called as starch. Okay, we are going to study a concept about starch. Now, when you compare glucose and starch, glucose and starch both are carbohydrates. Glucose and starch both are carbohydrates, but glucose is a simpler carbohydrate and starch is a complex carbohydrate. Okay, glucose is simple carbohydrate and starch is a complex carbohydrate. So now this starch, how is it produced? A very common example that I'm giving you, let's say you're not very hungry, but mummy has given you 4 chapatis, right? Now what are you going to do? Because you're not very hungry, you're going to eat only that much that you require to just fill up your stomach. So let's say out of 4 chapatis, you will be having around 2 chapatis, right? And the remaining 2 chapatis, you might just ask your mom to keep it somewhere in the a small tiffin box, so that, you know, maybe later on if you're feeling hungry, you can go and have that, right? So same case with the plant also. Now plant is continuously carrying out photosynthesis and plant is producing glucose, but that does not mean the plant is going to use all the glucose that it has produced. Are you understanding? Only when it requires, or only the amount of the glucose that is required by the plant, only that much amount the plant is going to utilize. Plant ko jitna chahiye glucose, plant sirf utna glucose khayega. That is utna food khayega. Glucose is what? Food for it, right? And the remaining amount of glucose that is present, that remaining amount of glucose is going to be converted into starch. It is going to be converted into starch. So starch is a reserve food material in plant. Starch is a reserve food material in plant. So this starch will be used when plant is not able to carry out photosynthesis. Like very simple, when nothing is available for us to eat, okay, then we are not going to die immediately. Arey yaar, aadha ghanta khana nahi mila, hum mar jayenge, ya 4 ghanta khana nahi mila, hum mar jayenge. No, we have got reserve food material. What is that reserve food material in us? Fats. So whenever we are going to use it, whenever we are not going to eat food, that time that reserve food material is going to be broken down for obtaining energy. So same way, when the plant is not going to produce food or not going to carry out photosynthesis, this starch is going to be used up by the plants for energy purpose. Okay, so starch is the reserve food material in plants, which is produced by photosynthesis. Why am I saying it is produced by photosynthesis? Because by photosynthesis, only if glucose is produced, the glucose that is not used up by the plant, or the unused glucose, I can call it as, that unused glucose is going to be converted into starch. So if glucose is produced by photosynthesis, then definitely starch is going to be produced. Hope you have understood. Yes, give me a thumbs up if you have understood till here. Okay. Mustaba, Sai, have you understood? Fine. If you are having any doubts, you can just message me. Again, I'm repeating. Okay, so let's go ahead. Now let's proceed. Okay, one more thing. We are only left with 5 minutes. Okay, 5 minutes, 20 seconds or something like that. So ma'am has already sent the second link on the group. So the moment this lecture automatically gets cancelled, I want you all to immediately click on the second link that is provided to you all in the group. Okay. Now let's proceed. So you can just see this. Whatever amount of glucose is required by the plant is utilized, and the rest is converted into a complex carbohydrate, which is called as starch. Okay. Now we are going to study something about the next thing, which is called as experiment on photosynthesis. What are we going to study about? Experiment on photosynthesis. That is, under this experiment on photosynthesis, we are basically going to study about to show that chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis, to show that sunlight is necessary for photosynthesis, and to show that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis. So these three experiments we are going to talk about in this particular lecture, and we'll continue in the second lecture also. So, but always remember, whenever we do any experiment on photosynthesis, for all the experiments, two steps are common. For all the experiments, two steps are common. Let us see which are those two steps. The first step is called as destarching. Anagha. Okay, the first step is called as destarching. And the second step is called as iodine test. I'll tell you what are these steps, but just understand that always for any experiment on photosynthesis, these two steps are going to be common, destarching and iodine test. Okay, destarching and iodine test. So let us understand what is destarching. Destarching basically means removal of starch. Destarching basically means removal of starch. Now, like I told you, like let's say I have locked you in a room and I'm not giving you food for 3-4 days. Okay. Now, what have I told you? Just because I'm not going to give you food for 3-4 days, yeah, you'll feel tired. Okay. But that doesn't mean immediately you'll die. Okay. Minimum, it will take 2 weeks, 1.5 weeks for you to die. If I don't, in that entire period, I don't give you food, right? But I'm just talking about 2-3 days. So in that 2-3 days, you will feel tired, but still you're not dying. Why? Because your body is getting the required energy. How? The reserve food material, like I told you, right? So whatever food material is stored in your body, glycogen, fats, they are all going to be broken down. And when they are broken down, energy is going to be utilized. Ultimately, after 3-4 days, after 5 days, after 6 days, still I don't give you food, what will happen? What will happen? Ultimately, all the reserve food material in your body is going to be completely utilized. And when there is no reserve food material in your body, and so your body will stop getting energy. And what will happen? You will die, right? So I don't want to kill you all. So what am I supposed to do? So I'm just keeping you in that room for 2-3 days, right? So same way. So why am I keeping you in that room for 2-3 days? I want to remove all the reserve food material in your body. I want to remove all the reserve food material from your body. Same way, in plants, the reserve food material is starch. Okay. I want to remove all this starch from the plant. Why? And all I'll tell you in detail when we come to the experiments on photo. But understand, how do we do destarching right now? Yeah. So I'm going to keep this plant in a dark room for 2-3 days. Repeating once again, I'm keeping this plant in a dark room for 2-3 days. So dark room means there is no sunlight. And without sunlight, plants cannot carry out photosynthesis. And without photosynthesis, plants cannot produce their food. Unka khana nahi ban sakta. So do you think in that 2-3 days, plants will die? No. Plant is already having starch, the reserve food material. So starch will be broken down completely in that 2-3 days. So that the plants get their energy to carry out their functions. Now, after 2-3 days, if I still keep the plant in a dark room, then definitely the plant will die. Again, I don't want to kill the plant. I want to use that plant for my experiment. So that is why I am going to remove the starch from the plant by keeping that plant in a dark room for 2 to 3 days. So this is the mechanism by which I will destarch the plant, or simply I will remove the starch from the plant. Have you understood? Give me a thumbs up if you have understood. Okay. You understood? Fine.